It gives us immense pleasure and indeed a great honor to request our guest of honor, Mr. Ram Jaldurgam, to address the budding generation for today's inaugural event.
Hey, hi. Donate a smile, please. Oh, I'm so happy. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Wonderful.
Person died and went to hell. He saw there's a huge crowd. For different countries, different hells were there. He wanted to just check what's happening in Russian hell, in American hell, in Indian hell, German hell, the lot of hells. He stopped at one hell and inquired what's happening inside. So he just checked him, what's happening in this hell. He stopped at the Russian hell and asked them. They said, sir, first 1 hour they'll make you sit on an electrical chair. They'll give an electricity to the chair. Second 1 hour they make you lie on the bed of nails. And the rest of the day, one person will come and beat you up. That's what is the hell here. Oh, is it? Then he went to a German hell and he asked, what's happening here? They said, no, sir, first 1 hour you'll have to sit on an electrical chair. You will experience that, and the second 1 hour, they'll make you lie on the nails. And then third, the person will come and beat you up. So more or less all the countries, hell, punishments in the hell is the same. And he found that there is a huge line before the Indian hell, rather than any other hell. He was surprised. He just asked, hey, what's happening here in the Indian hell? They said, first 1 hour, they'll make you sit on the electrical chair. Second 1 hour, they'll make you lie on the bed of nails. The third 1 hour, person will, hey, what is this? More or less the same. Why the crowd is huge in the Indian hell? Then somebody said, sir, here on electricity, electrical chair, electricity is not there. There is a power cut. And there are some thieves, they have stolen the nails on the bed. There are no nails at all. And the person who is supposed to come and beat you up the rest of the day is a government employee. He will come for 1 hour, next 1 hour he will go to the canteen and go sign there and will not go there. No, what I want to say is that now there's no situation like that. There is a heavy competition, either it's a government or a private. There is a competition for the business ideas. And there is a competition for business leaders to convert your ideas into the business concepts. It's not that easy. Don't expect that people embrace you with your ideas because you have a business idea. Every successful business was once upon a time is a foolish idea. Today your idea also will be foolish. I am saying, if you come with an idea and somebody will appreciate your idea, business idea is wonderful and this works very well, please don't trust that. If everybody accepts, that's not a creative idea at all. First, people ridicule you. People doubt you. People do not accept. And you need to be confident and you need to be self-motivated. I found the student that new startups or the students who come from the business school fresh are the four categories. Number one are the people, those who blame always, they are called victimizers. They feel that they're all victimized for many situations. With the situation, they are victimized by the college. They are victimized by the economic status, with their family, background, political status, the government policies. There are many things that they make them victimized, so they feel that I am victimized, that's why my business idea is not successful. The second category are the sustainers. What they think is that just because I came from the premier business school, whatever I start, that is supposed to be successful and it will be successful, that's all. Because I have a higher degree, the entire world will accept me and embrace me and I'll be successful. These are all sustainers. The third category are the dreamers. they'll have a wonderful dreams. They always live in dreams, day and night. They share their dreams with everyone. And they only live in dreams, they won't wake up. They need to learn is that it's not just dreams, not enough. To make it realize, you'll have to wake up. The fourth category are the winners. The winners are the people, those who grow in all kinds of situations, particularly the odd situations. These are like a lotus, the lotus which grows in the mud water, but lotus will never carry the smell of mud or the color of mud or the influence of the mud. A lotus will grow as an independently in a very odd situation. That's why gods and goddesses choose to sit on the lotus only. So winners are like a lotus. If you want to be a winner, be a lotus. Don't expect that every condition, every situation will be very comfortable. You need to fight with all the odds. There's a concept called, you need to believe in yourself that conditions are not controlling you. You can control the conditions. That's why we call VUCA world. The world is VUCA, volatile, uncertain, chaotic, ambiguous. In this VUCA world, having higher expectations of the world without your efforts, without your determination, without you sticking to your dreams and your vision, you cannot become a business leader. To be a business leader, believe in yourself. Also, executive presence is very important. I just wanted to tell you this for the next generation. Executive presence is, which is an upcoming and emerging topic, where a lot of people failed in these professions just because they do not have an executive presence. Executive presence is that how you carry yourself, how confident are you, how can you instill confidence in others to believe you. Probably it may be investors or your customers or your bankers, whoever it is, and how do you make them believe in you? That's called, and there are three elements. One is a gravitas. Gravitas is that your emotional intelligence. I'm telling you, if you take this new generation have got a very new characteristics. Those characteristics that are, they have less patience, they have less focus, they cannot sit at one place for a long time to work. I'm not saying these are all disadvantages. They may have advantages. Convert that as an advantage. And you need to have a patience. The people, those who are all sitting on the dais with a great experience, with a lot of patience, they believed in themselves, they have come to this state. That's why it took more than at least 2 to 3 pages to make their profile so impressive to all of you. It's not that easy. And you also need to learn from the present generation how they have come up in their life. The combination of your quickness, also their patience, you need to learn a lot of lessons in life. With all these, probably come with the business ideas, with a great confidence in yourself, that is with emotional intelligence, that is a gravitas. The second piece of this executive presence is your communication. Very, very important. Be very precise, very assertive, very confident. In fact, confidence is abused and overused word. A lot of people use the word confidence. People do not know what the meaning of confidence. Confidence is an outcome of the previous success. Confidence is nothing but a clarity. People are not confident when they don't have a clarity. Have clarity, you will get confident. If you are getting onto the dais first time, you are not confident because you don't have any clarity how the audience will respond and what kind of situation you will have to face here. Get clarity, you get confidence. So your communication needs to be very clear, concise, precise, and then assertive. The last one is an appearance. How do you appear before your customer is very important. The appearance piece is a 7%, but that's also important. And do you know how much time it takes for anybody to create an impression in their minds or their opinions about you? All these days, people used to believe it takes 8 seconds for anyone to create an impression. But in the recent research in Harvard University says is 1/10 of second is enough for anyone to create an opinion about you in their minds. So how do you appear, how do you communicate, and how do you carry yourself makes a lot of difference. All those things, compiling, having your business ideas and believing in them, have a strong vision, you will definitely be successful and you will go forward. Thank you so much. Once again, Happy New Year.
Thank you so much, sir, for such a motivational speech. Definitely, we are so much glad to know that we have victimizers, sustainers, and dreamers, and winners and startups. And I'm sure all of here present students in the auditorium would like to be in the category of winners one day. Thank you so much, sir.
Now, I request Commodore Siddharth Mishra, Chairman and Managing Director, Bharat Dynamics Limited, to deliver the inaugural address.
Good morning. Mr. K. Madhav Rao, President of IPE, Shri Ram Jal Durgam, Professor R. K. Mishra, Professor Srimas Murthy, Ms. Bhavani Pucha, distinguished faculty, and future captain of industries. It is indeed a pleasure to be here in presence of you, and I am really delighted to be part of the flagship event of this IPE Sanskriti being held at the beautiful campus of your institute. IPE is one of the best and premier business school in the country and has the tradition of producing world-class business captains. At the outset, I must compliment Ms. Monica for her excellent performance which she has done before starting off this function. It is indeed a pleasure to address you people who are young minds of today and potential CEOs of tomorrow, and most importantly, the responsible citizens. The business landscape of today has undergone a sea change in last 2-3 decades. The IT revolution, policy of the government, emergence of startups, private sector participation in industry, and activities of hitherto which were the exclusive domain of certain sectors, especially in the defense industry, have opened up a plethora of opportunities for the young managers to prove their mettle in global business environment. I'm sure the students of IPE will have the required business acumen to deal with the future challenges of business. I would like to dwell upon one of the most important aspects of business today, which you must have studied in your curriculum, that is adaptation to change. It is one of the areas of business management where management gurus have contributed volumes of information to ensure that the survival of fittest in the industry prevails. Some of the most common change drivers include technological evolution, process reviews, crisis and consumer habits. But one of the biggest driver for change that I have observed in today's industrial scenario is technological evolution. Technology is changing at a very rapid pace, and one needs to adopt for survival. You might be aware that many giants cease to exist for not adopting to new technologies. The present-day business establishments need to adopt themselves to survive in the changing environment. This requires specialized skills, better knowledge, management, product innovation to be able to continue to exist in this market. The second aspect that I would like to impress upon, as you are especially at the crossroads of your career, is that think big and be ambitious. It is not enough to simply try and get into the life that does not move the world forward. You must strive to excel in everything you do. Excellence in every task, large or small. The decisions you make starting today will determine that what you become in future. You must think big, dream based on not what is, but on what might be. I'm glad to know that there are many startups, companies who are representing here and participating in this event. Government is boosting startup like never before. I have been observing the recent past that both central government and Telangana government are encouraging startups. BDL has entered into MOU with the best of in the world to transform itself from being pioneer in the missile manufacturing in the market leader. The company is encouraging startups. The technical startups incubator, T-Hub, is all set to play host to clutch and startups selected under a defense ministry initiative to bolster self-reliance in the field of defense production. BDL has signed an MOU with T-Hub. Recent trends indicate rapid strides are being made by countries over the global in utilizing artificial intelligence based technologies for development of the next generation for weapon systems. Taking cognizance of this fact, BDL has started undertaking development of products for the armed forces with AI technologies with active participation of startups. The company has entered into an MOU with International Institute of Information Technology, Hyderabad, last year for joint development of AI techniques for product development at BDL. The MOU envisages setting up of an exclusive center of excellence for artificial intelligence in missile technology. The center of excellence will function as an AI laboratory for BDL, building an understanding of BDL's product and business within the IIT Hyderabad is in research groups. Innovation always has been a key to success and growth of any country or a company. And BDL has always considered innovation as part of the R&D efforts. Synergy is being maintained between the industry and academia to sustain balance between experience and knowledge industry. BDL is encouraging startups companies to participate in the innovation programs of the country. This is being done in association with the Government of India, Ministry of Defense Wing, IDEX, that is Innovation of Defense Excellence, and Telangana State Government. In line with this, the purchase procedures have been amended to encourage more participation by startups and supplies from indigenous vendors with more indigenous content. Hyderabad is emerging as a defense hub, having presence of companies like BDL, HAL, Bell, DRDO Labs, and Ordnance Factory, and a number of private companies are being set up. This gives a number of opportunities to young managers for fast-track growth in area like production, management, finance, HR, marketing, IT, etc. I am being closely associated with defense manufacturing sector. Foresee vast opportunities for managers like you in defense sector. The only prerequisite to this is to aim high, update your skills and knowledge in tune with the requirement of the industry, and let the trajectory of your career path reach greater heights. But one thing I must tell you, after you pass out from this establishment, you must have your work-life balance. You have to ensure that career is one Work life is another. You must take care of your parents. You must respect your teachers. You must ensure that you inculcate some hobby. Pick up some instrument. You learn an instrument. It will soothe you. It will make you a good human. It is very it is very essential that you have a command over language. You must work on yourself. Ensure that your command over language is good. Then only you will be able to face the world, and especially in the business world. Also, you must give back to society. Get into some sort of social work. Get into Swachhta Abhiyan. Government of India is doing so much in this. You must work in this. A person like you, at this young age, if you get into such type of leadership, you will become one of the champions of the society. At the final advice to you, be honest, be hardworking. Whatever intelligence you have, in case you do not have hard work in your nature, you will not be able to grow where you should try and strive for. So with this, I wish each one of you for a bright future. Thank you, and Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir, for highlighting us on very important areas that we need to focus, like adaptation to change, technological evaluations, and startup innovations and initiatives. And sir, we definitely will ensure to aim high, update our skills, and be a better person every day and give back to the society. Thank you, sir. Let me take the pride and honor by requesting our Honorable President, Board of Governors, IPE, Shri K. Madhav Rao, to deliver the presidential address.
Good morning, everybody. Commodore Siddharth Mishra, Mr. Ram Jaladurgam, Dr. Mishra, and Dr. Murthy, and Ms. Swapna. Students who have come from other B schools and registered with us, and our own children from IP. I understand that about 252 students from other institutes have registered, in addition to the home group of about 150. It's a fairly good number. Some are here, some are in the stalls. Maybe some are watching the beautiful greenery outside. I'm thrilled that this is the Silver Jubilee of a tongue-twisting acronym, Sanskrit, covering various branches of the business school learning by Dr. Mishra. What do we tell the students when they gather here? We had met here a few months back for our first convocation. And I recall what students were at that time. They're passing out, taking their degrees, they're taking their PG degrees and the diploma degrees. Now, most of you, I find, when you pass out from the business school, about 90% of you end up in a private industry. A very small number, around 1%, are going for higher studies. About 4% are in their family business or a startup. And the remaining 5%, Dr. Mishra tells me, are the miscellaneous categories. They disappear from the radar of IPE. So now, we address this 90%. We expect you to do well to yourself, to your family, and to the company which you join, or the one which you start. But is that all? We, several crores of people in the country, for that matter it applies to all the countries, we don't live just by individual entities. There is a society. It is a society that provides these facilities. It's a society that elects a government. It's a society that elects its leaders. It could be prime minister, it could be the president. So you don't exist without the society, and the society consists of you all, we all. There is an interconnection, an umbilical cord, which is never cut. When a child is born, the umbilical cord is cut. The baby is on her own, on his own. But this umbilical cord between the individual and the society is never cut. If it is cut, there is no orderliness. If it is cut, there is no progress. So one contributes the other. The society contributes to each one of you. When I say society, it's interchangeable with the government, with the state. What does society give you, and what do you give to the society? Think of a great technocrat, Mr. Narayan Murthy. Could have become that great, but for the society. What did society give him? He gave him a school which is recognized by the government. It gave him a college which is recognized by the government. It gave him a license to set up an industry. It gave him an export permit. It gave him a passport to go out of India, otherwise you can't enter any other country. Now the same applies to every one of the industrialists, every one of the employees. So this is the connection between the society and the individual. And when the individual is getting so much from the society, what is he giving in return? I said, without individual, there is no society. And if you don't contribute to the society, you are busy all the time looking after yourself, your family, and maybe future generations of your family, who will work for the society. It is not the paid employee. And he gave a beautiful story of the paid employee in the hell segment of the hell, Indian segment of the hell. So when we had the convocation, I said, as you leave the portals of this institution with a degree for a job elsewhere, what do I expect as a person? to remind you that you came this far because of the society and the government. And you, in turn, should give back your share, not as a charity, but as a duty, as a sense of gratitude. We are grateful to our parents for bringing us up. The society is a bigger family. And so we have a duty for that society. Now, be successful entrepreneur. But is that all again? Is it life? Life is only to make money, get higher positions, get a good name as a wonderful, successful business leader. The great scientist Einstein said, the successful person is one who takes maximum from the society and gives little or nothing back to the society. A useful, a purposeful, a grateful person is one who takes least from the society and gives maximum back to the society. He is not a sociologist, he is not a political leader, he is a scientist. But he visioned that the way that an ideal citizen is one of this category or the other. The first category, purposeful, useful, grateful, 3-4 names will sound the bell. Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, here in India, Premji, Tatas. But the one who takes maximum and gives very little back, one name is enough. I have nothing personal against him, and that is Mahesh Ambani. What's his worth? Where did he get it from? All the industry that he has captained, owns, comes from the society, from the government. No industry, even IT, can ever exist without the assistance, permission, regulation by the government. Why did Bill Gates give away most of his fortune? That is his responsibility to the society that made him what he is. I am successful because I think I am a good student, so I got a good job. I did very well in my job. I got my promotions, so I owe nothing to nobody, if I can use the African-American language. I owe nothing to nobody. That's not correct. The human journey started with a caveman. He was alone. Then it was a small group of people who came together to protect themselves from the wild animals. That's how our journey started. There was a leader to guide the group. The one group fought with the other, became a bigger group. A bigger group fought another and became another bigger group. Then you have the kingdoms, empires. All this resulted in one group subjugating, eliminating a weaker group. After the civilized countries came, what did they do? Invasion of one country by the other. Ending up with World War I, World War II. Then arose the League of Nations to say that we all must do something to see that there is no Third World War. It evolved into United Nations Organization. It did well for some time. And now we are going back in the reverse direction of regionalization, ASEAN, European Union, African Union. So this is a circle going on. But the central point is the individual, not versus, and the society. When I was talking to the children in the convocation last time, I told them the story of Uguntu. It's a Zulu tribe. A Western anthropologist goes to a village, gathers youngsters, they are in the age group of 6 to 10, and he keeps a basket of fruits near a tree, keeps these children away from them, and says that whoever runs from this point where I am standing to the tree, reaches that basket of the fruit, he will get all the fruits to himself. And then he says, ready, set, go. And instead of students rushing to reach first, the Zulu tribe group, not students, children, they hold each other's hand and run together. They reach the basket and share the fruits among themselves. He asked them, why did you do it? If you ran on your own, you'd have got the whole basket for themselves. The answer is Ubuntu. The meaning, we are, I am here because we are. We are here because I am. We are inseparable. Now, some of the faculty members who are present in the convocation, they would be saying, my president is repeating the same story. But this is a story which I will tell everywhere, every time. You know, there is what is called Ramakoti. When you write Rama, Rama, again and again, till you reach that number of 1 crore, you would end up in heaven. My Ramakoti is Ubuntu. I don't believe in hell and heaven, but I'm believing in we living together, not one at the expense of the other, but all together. So let's, from here, have that Ubuntu movement and be a useful citizen and be a purposeful citizen. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable insight. It will really help all of us in our journey to progress and prosper. Thank you once again.
On this occasion of celebrating the Silver Jubilee year of Sanskriti, we would like to cherish the journey IPE had so far.
Here, we are presenting you the souvenir of IPE Sanskriti 2020, Excellence Personified.
I request the dignitaries on stage to release the souvenir.
As a token of gratitude and appreciation, I request our President Shri K. Madhav Rav Garu to felicitate our Chief Guest Commodore Siddharth Mishra.
As a token of gratitude and appreciation, I request Director R.K. Mishra to felicitate our guest of honor, Mr. Ram Jaldurgam. I request our Director R.K. Mishra sir to present a memento to our Honorable President Board of Governors IPE, Shri K. Madhav Rav Garu. A dream doesn't become reality through a magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work. This Sanskriti 2020 Excellence Personified and Startupedia 2020 Rocket Your Business Ideas is the hard work of many.
Now, I call upon Ms. Bhavani, our Sanskriti 2020 Core Team Student Coordinator, to propose the oath of thanks for the inaugural ceremony.
A very good afternoon, everyone. I take this great pride and privilege to propose a vote of thanks for Sanskriti 2020 Excellence Personified Inauguration Ceremony. At the outset, let me thank our Honorable President, Board of Governors of IPE, Shri K. Madhav Rav Garu, for enriching this inauguration ceremony with your presence in spite of your busy schedules. Let me equally with great pride thank our Chief Guest, Commodore Siddharth Mishra, Chairman and Managing Director of Bharat Dynamics Limited. I express my gratefulness and thank our guest of honor, Mr. Ram Jaldurgam, Senior Manager, Learning and Development, Hetero Group of Companies, for sharing his valuable experiences with all of us today and gracing our event. I thank our director, Mishra sir, for his continuous support and motivation, which helped us to work on this event throughout. I thank our Dean Murthy sir for his valuable suggestions and constant engagement with us on this event. I also thank our Student Affair Coordinator, Mr. Anand Kumar sir, who has been helping us in each and every part of the event. I thank our event sponsors, title sponsor Bharat Dynamics Limited, associate sponsors Vivo and Icons, and I also thank our co-sponsors, Planet Finance, Talent Sprint, Prism Hospitality Services, United India Insurance Corporation, Mangal Tube Corporation, Rachanotsav, Uchvas, KK Jewelers for their sponsorship to Sanskriti 2020. I thank our event sponsors, Learning While Traveling, TheCollegeFever.com, 50K Ventures, Chatur Ideas, Vadhvani Foundation, 91 Springboard, Clowwork, The Coffic, The New Indian Express, Saplinks, CII IWN for their sponsorship for Startupedia. I thank our faculty, administrative staff, and management of IP for their constant support and help in presenting us this event. I thank all the participants and their college management who have come here to participate and witness the cultural learning experience through Sanskriti. I thank my co-student coordinators, all the event coordinators, organizers, volunteers for their extreme efforts in bringing this event to you all. I thank the Masters of Ceremony, Mr. Suryakiran Joshila and Ms. Anjusha for hosting this grand inaugural event. I also thank all the student friends of all the departments for their constant engagement, involvement, and dedication towards Sanskriti and Startupedia. My sincere and best wishes to all the participants, and I firmly believe that you will be amazed and have a great fun-filled learning in these 2 days. May you cherish Sanskriti 2020 and Startupedia 2020 and reap rich fruits of success. Thank you so much for this opportunity.
I once again take this opportunity and thank all the dignitaries on stage for their presence and making this 25th year of Sanskriti 2020 a memorable one. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much for being an amazing audience. Of Sanskriti will start in their respective classrooms at 1 p.m. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.